Hey, talk.
Say sorry for me.
Top went up the dark. Hey, post it and put top rank after dark.
Team Uber.
Next photo shoot would be on the 7th train.
Nobody. We couldn't finish. It ended in the top. We couldn't finish because it was arguing too much.
You won the ping pong game, right?
Yeah, I won the ping pong shootout.
Well, he already knows that.
Come on, turn.
Who won the last games?
It was me.
No, you didn't win the 8 games.
You gotta play me now, though. I've been practicing a lot for you. I'm coming. Mike, you can't
be good. I'm confused. No more. No, he good. He good in that. That's his lane.
Nah,
I'm like, what is that? No, we
pressure or blessing? People say you're number one.
It's a blessing because it gets motivated and add fuel to the fire, and then, you know, and then get the cooking wrong.
You feel like this is the biggest stage right here in New York?
One of them. They can be a big stage. As well as New York.
Terrence, you plan on sending a message to all the 147 families?
Oh, man, I do my message in the ring. You know, they see what I do this weekend, and then that's going to be my message to all the 147 families.
You think the fact that Earl's out there, that y'all can get a fight with Keith or Sean, they don't got no belt, and you the one with the belt, you make it a lot easier, or it's just politics for politics?
I don't know, man. That's a question you're going to have to ask there. I can't answer the question.
Do you think this guy poses a threat? Machine?
Everybody opposes a threat. This guy is a dangerous fighter. He's a two-time Olympian. You know, he's earned the right to be here right now. He's undefeated. He's strong. He's hungry. He got everything to win. Nothing to lose, really. So, you know what I mean? He makes for them dangerous fights that you got to prepare for.
You're comfortable coming to your second home? You be very comfortable.
I'm comfortable anywhere I'm at. You know, as long as I got four quarters and a square ring.
How much is it to be a unified champ in 2020?
I gotta get those fighters to get in the ring with me first.
When you unified at 140, you said that you're gonna be the most famous guy walking the Cracker Barrel now in Omaha. What's it gonna, now that you're 147, you're arguably the best pound for pound fighter. What's it like now and being walking around Omaha?
It's the same, you know. People greet me in the same way as if I was 135. You know, I've been around since amateur days, so, you know, some people come up on pictures, some people just come to shake my hand and just say, what's up?
So it's good to be the champ.
Do you open a new boutique or something? Or?
Apparel store.
Apparel?
Yeah, I'll open it.
Nice.
My last ultimate goal is to become undisputed at 147. I didn't accomplish everything else that I accomplished. You know, that's the last goal. You know, to say.
Notice you're not throwing hands right now, you're not really working out. Is that like become something that you don't do? Is that a decision on your own?
Same working out today, work out afterwards.
This is just a scrum now in the ring.
I like
this. So this is for show, then.
All the work's done, right?
What do you say to the naysayers that would say that you're on the wrong side of the street in order to feel comfortable to be an artist at 47? You're on the wrong side of the street and you have to essentially move to get to make that happen.
I just say it's all of you guys that speak for the people that are on the side of the street. There's no such thing as the wrong side of the street in the sport of boxing. When you look at it, Deontay Wilder, it's about to fight Tyson Fury, and you never heard anything about wrong side of the street, like PBC or Top Rank. It's just something that they say when they got Terrence Crawford to do it. You know, you don't never hear wrong side of the street from other fighters but Terrence Crawford. You know, then the media say, oh, well, he's on the wrong side of the street, he should have signed with PBC. But why all these other fights get made but when it's Terrence Crawford, oh, he's on the wrong side of the street?
So, Jamal Charles said this weekend in Brooklyn, Jamal Charles was on one side of the street in that division.
He said, Christmas,
man, you know, since he got on the side of the street, those fights, they can get made, it's just more about money.
How much does that bother you, the fact that that's a narrative that's universal?
It really too much don't bother me as much as people think. I didn't accomplish more than all those welterweights over there except Pacquiao. Mm. You know, if you look at what I've accomplished in the sport of boxing, and if you look at what Errol, Keith, Sean, Danny Garcia, all those other welterweights over there, I didn't accomplish way more than each and every one of them except Pacquiao.
You think they need you? You don't need them?
I really don't need them. Thank you.
Do you think that the Wilder Fury fight, the collaboration between Fox and ESPN, could potentially help you land the fights that you want?
No, that's just show that they can do business together. Because those two fighters want to fight each other. And I'm pretty sure they went to the business avenue and said, make the fight happen.
Yeah, but now the avenues are open. Like, the guys that are going to make the decisions, the executives are talking to make this fight, they're going to say, hey, why don't we make Terrence Crawford versus Errol Spence, Terrence Crawford versus put down the list.
Any fight can get made. Any fight can get made.
You think it would take a bad Terrence Crawford performance to essentially make that fight happen?
It ain't about a bad performance. You know, one bad performance leads to another, so it really don't matter.
But I mean, you're, like, in other words, you're saying that like you're so good that maybe that's why they wouldn't want to fight you, so maybe a bad performance would go to you.
That's something that I can't answer.
You still want the Pacquiao fight? Pacquiao or Floyd? Who do you want more?
Pacquiao.
Logan Paul? Logan Paul?
Logan Paul.
Exactly. You don't know who he is.
We can fight outside the ring.
YouTube guy.
Yo, he can fight.
You can put
it
on YouTube?
Terrence, piggybacking what he said, like Charlo was saying that he feels like he's in a situation like you and that we all look at this situation differently than him because he's like, you know, you got to take the fights that you can, you got to keep it moving because this is how we feed our family. So we see it completely different than you guys. You agree with that?
Of course. You know, y'all look at us fighters and say, oh, he's not fighting
right
a top opponent, and y'all really ain't did y'all history on the opponent. You know, like, I look at Mean Machine as a good opponent, mm-hmm. quality opponent. You know, he's a two-time Olympian, never lost before. Yeah, he had a close fight with Ray Robinson.
Yeah.
But Ray Robinson is an awkward fighter.
Yeah.
You know, a dude can fight and know what he's doing, and it makes for a great fight.
Ray was actually the last guy to beat you, right, in the amateurs? Oh, he wasn't.
Who was that guy?
Who was it? Miguel Gonzalez.
Oh, okay.
When was that?
In the trials. In the Olympic trials. Last guy to
beat him. Okay. Because, you know, Ray...
Ray talks.
Ray been...
just talk because he thinks somebody listening to him.
Well, you say the word... I know Earl, before his accident, was saying that your numbers are not low. Or not high enough for him to get in the ring with you. You feel like you have to put out some numbers?
That's an excuse. If I fought those same opponents that he fought...
When you first heard about his car accident, what were you thinking when you first heard about the news?
I was hoping it was all right. You know, I sent him a text message. You know, I told him that I wish him well. I hope he get back to him before he left.
You guys text? You guys are friendly?
No, no, we don't text, but I got his number. He got my number. I'll send him a text, wish him well. You know, I don't want nothing bad to happen. You know, especially outside of boxing, right? Like that. So, you know, I know he got a family to look out for, you know, two daughters, whatnot. You know, gotta take care of him.
Tyson Fury sends Anthony Joshua random text messages in the middle of the night, says you're a chump. We don't do that.
Kids folks don't do that.
Psychological. It's not your style.
Spence never makes it back to the point where it would be kind of bittersweet for you that you look at that fight with him.
Leave the sport if you don't get back. But at the same time, you decisions you make. It's not knocking to it.
You made it clear you're going to be the king at 147.
I am the king.
For whatever reason, you can't get the big
pay-per-view
fights at
the Colts,
and then you
get
to see
that
140
with Ramirez
and those guys.
140? Yeah, exactly. No, I'm going back down to 35. Now listen. Can you make 140? Now listen. When I was at 140, everybody criticized me and said I was too big for 140. Like they criticized me and said I was too big for 135. Now, if I was to go back down to 140, what would everybody say? I'm picking and bullying people, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you make 140?
Can I make 140? Yeah. Of course.
If you went up to 154, they wouldn't say that.
I'm going to 160.
Who's that? Triple G at 160?
Charlo? No, Triple G at 168.
You want that Charlo?
I'm going to 160. Whoever.
Yeah. So when you fight,
you think I'm playing? I'm going to 160.
You've been 160 in 2020. In 2020, you're going to be at 160.
My next fight, I'm going to 160.
One more, guys.
Who would you like to see? Do they have to have a belt, or does it have to be a name?
Gonna beat up Canelo.
Canelo at 178.
Oh, I mean, you know, if you go.
What's inspiring that decision? If you are being serious, what's inspiring that decision?
Just cause. Yeah, when I beat this guy, they're gonna say, well, you gotta fight Canelo. Canelo at 178, so I might as well beat up 178.
Hey, don't leave. I'm gonna take a little media picture of my parents.
At 147?
The last undisputed.
Who was it?
Seven of
them. There you go.
Thank you, Terrence.
The next one.
Yeah. Everybody, thanks for coming out. I just want to get a quick picture with you, with all the media came. With Terrence, if that's cool.
All right, cool.
You guys want to jump in the ring?
Computers are going to be given to all their stores. They're going to be there. They're going to sell them.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.